Hello everyone, welcome back to another lecture of process modeling and simulation. I am your course instructor engineer Mohammad Haris Humayo, working as lecturer at Department of Chemical Engineering, Comsearch University, Islamabad Lahore campus, and the module which we are following these days is related to the unit process modeling. So if I take you to the exercises, we have so far covered mixer simulation, stream splitter simulation, and simulation of flash separator. Our next task is to simulate a decanter. So let's quickly go to the simulation exercise. What are the simulation requirements and how we can achieve our required results? Just like previous simulation tasks, this simulation task is also linked with CLO number 1, which is the fundamental or basics of this course, and CLO number 2, which is related to the simulation of the equipment in Aspen Plus. So there are two objectives of the simulation. Number one is knowing how to do liquid-liquid separation by using the solubility principle in Aspen Plus. Basically, decanter is used to separate a liquid from another liquid. Means it's a mixture of a liquid and the both of them are separated. Recognize the way of using decanter model in Aspen Plus. So the problem description is that the perform the liquid-liquid separation of the mixture, and the mixture which is given is paraxylene and water by using specific stream conditions. That means those conditions which are provided to you in the problem, and determine the composition of each component. Paraxylene in one of the phase and water in other phase of each components in upper and lower phase at a temperature of 40 degrees centigrade and a pressure of 1 bar. Selecting the component, selecting the fluid package, it is related with CLO number 1, and simulating the decanter and to achieve our required results is related with CLO number 2. Attention, decanter is used only for liquid phase from the input to output stream. Means whenever you have a liquid stream and it's a pure liquid stream with vapor fraction as 0, then you can use decanter for the separation of liquid-liquid. If vapor is involved, then you will go to the flash separator. And degree of freedom in decanter is 2. It means you have to define a minimum of 2 parameters to satisfy or to converge the decanter or to simulate the decanter. The pressure must be specified. It means in any case, you have to specify pressure as well. And the other property could either be the temperature or ड्यूटी. इसका मतलब है कि आपके पास तीन पैरामीटर्स हैं, प्रेशर, टेम्परेचर, ड्यूटी, और उसमें से प्रेशर तो आपने लाजमी डिफाइन करना है, तो पीछे बचे टेम्परेचर और ड्यूटी. तो टेम्परेचर और ड्यूटी में से आपको ये एक स्पेसिफाई कर सकते हैं. सिंस इट्स अ केमिकल सिस्टम एंड एट लो प्रेशर. लो प्रेशर मीन्स द फीड इज एंटरिंग एट 1 ATM, 30 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड, 2000 kg/h, एंड द प्रेशर इन दिस डिकेंटर इज 1 bar. So it means it's a low pressure system and it's a chemical system, paraxylene, water. So if you remember my first lecture, which was related to the thermodynamic property package, we will select NRTL property package over here. And the feed stream contains 50% weight paraxylene and 50% weight water. It means we will specify the mass fraction of paraxylene as 0.5 and water as 0.5 in the feed stream, with flow rate as 2000 kg/h. It means the mass flow rate. Temperature 30 degree centigrade, pressure 1 atm, and in decanter we will specify these two conditions. So our first task, as you know, is to check the units, or you can specify the title, it's up to you. It's an optional step. You can do it, or even you do not do it, there is no harm. Then you will select the paraxylene and water as your components. Then you will select NRTL property package, binary parameters. Then you will come here in the flow sheet and you will select decanter. And then you will do the required connections of feed inlet, lower and upper. Then you will specify the feed. Then you will provide the information about the decanter, the minimum requirements, degree of freedom. And then you will run the decanter and you will obtain your results. This is the decanter results, the outlet temperature, pressure, duties, and the flow rates of outlet streams. So let's quickly go to Aspen Plus and solve it. Paraxylene and water are selected. Click next and select NRTLS property package. Again, click next. Estimate using UNIFAC. Click run. And after that, results are available on running. And results available, go to simulation. And in separator, you see the decanter is placed over here. Two-phase liquid-liquid decanter. Iski ek jo type hai ya ek shape hai, aap dekh rahe hain. Agar aap ispe click karein, scroll menu pe, to aap ye wali shape bhi select kar sakte hain. And you can select one of these shape as per your requirement, but we will select by default shape, which is decanter. So we will name it as decanter. And let me expand it a bit and placing the name to make it. And then we will select material stream. And you see there is one inlet connection and two outlet connections. So first we will give the connection of feed stream. We will label it as feed. This is second liquid. This is first liquid. So in the slides, it was written as upper and lower, but you can also specify it as first liquid and second liquid. It's up to you. Now specify the feed stream conditions that it is a 30 degree centigrade, 1 atm, so convert it to atm. The mole flow rate is not provided. The mass flow rate is provided, which is 2000 kg per hour, and the mass composition. So you will select mass fraction over here, which is 0.5 and 0.5. When it's WT, weight percent, then you will specify mass fraction. When it's MOL percent, it means it is mole fraction. So after that, go to decanter and specify pressure, which is 1 bar, and temperature as 40 degrees centigrade. This is an optional step. Key components to identify second liquid phase in this case. However, when you are dealing with other liquids, then you may specify one component in a phase. So let me tell you how. Main aapko dikhata hun ki agar aap ye wala step nahi bhi karte aur simple aap run kar dete hain, click run and go to the results aur hum उस दोनों में कंपैरिजन करेंगे रिजल्ट्स का. तो स्ट्रीम रिजल्ट्स पे अगर आप जाएं तो आप देखें 30 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड 1.01325, 40 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड 1 बार 41 बार. गो टू मास फ्लो रेट. द इनिशियल मास फ्लो रेट वाज 2000 केजी पर आवर. फर्स्ट लिक्विड मास फ्लो रेट इज 1000.23, सेकंड वन इज 999.774. एंड इफ यू गो टू मास फ्रैक्शन देन यू सी एंड द पैराक्सिलीन इन फर्स्ट लिक्विड इज एप्रोक्सीमेटली 99.95% व्हाइल water in other phase 99.98%, and you can see the mass flow rate as well. Now go back to decanter and select paraxylene. Come back here and run it. Kya aapne paraxylene ko specify kar diya ki second liquid phase mein paraxylene heavier hoga. To ab decanter pe wapas aa jaye, isko run karke dekhe, to ye kya hoga ki ye sirf idhar ka udhar ho jayega, ki jo values yahan pe thi ab wo yahan pe chali gayi, lekin result sare ka sara same hai. Ya is tarah agar aap water ko specify kar denge to result sare ka sara same rahega. To aur agar aap nahi bhi specify karte तो कोई इश्यू नहीं, वो बाय डिफॉल्ट जो भी उसमें लाइटर और हैवियर ऑन वो सिलेक्ट करके. एंड गो टू रिजल्ट्स और रिजल्ट्स में आप देख लें आउटलेट टेम्परेचर, आउटलेट प्रेशर, हीट ड्यूटी. यू कैन कन्वर्ट इट फ्रॉम कैलोरीज पर सेकंड टू किलोवाट, व्हिच इज 13.7 हीट ड्यूटी व्हिच इज रिक्वायर्ड टू कैरी आउट दिस सेपरेशन, द प्रेशर ड्रॉप थ्रू दिस डिकेंटर. सो दैट्स हाउ यू सिमुलेट अ डिकेंटर इन एस्पन प्लस टू कैरी आउट लिक्विड लिक्विड सेपरेशन. दैट्स इट फ्रॉम दिस लेक्चर. थैंक यू.